Francis turbine. Here we need to learn about velocity triangle. It is similar with centrifugal pump. We need to draw velocity triangle before we could calculate any terms or parameter from Francis turbine. And one thing that you should know, Francis turbine is actually the reverse side of centrifugal pump. It means that if you want to calculate or you want to draw the velocity triangle for Francis turbine, what you need is you need to reverse all the velocity triangle of centrifugal pump. If you see this diagram, you will find that the inlet of Francis turbine is here. The outlet of Francis turbine is here. It is mean that the radius or the diameter for inlet is R1 and diameter for the inlet is D2 or R2 here. So the diameter for inlet is bigger compared to diameter for the outlet. And then we start our drawing with absolute velocity. So in inlet here, we draw an absolute velocity V1 like this. And then at the outlet here, we draw absolute velocity V2 like this. Same reason with the centrifugal pump. So we may draw absolute velocity for the outlet here parallel with the radius line here. It means that the V world velocity at outlet here is equal to zero. So we focus on the velocity triangle at the inlet. As I said, first we draw the absolute velocity V1, then we draw the component velocity due to the rotational. So we have tangential speed here, U1, and then we have VR1, velocity relative to the shape of blade. Then we draw the theoretical flow for the Francis turbine. We draw the flow velocity VF1 like this, parallel with the radial line here, and then we draw V1 like this. And for outlet here, first we draw the absolute velocity V2 like this, which is parallel with the radial line like this, and then we add the component velocity due to the rotational speed, which is the tangential speed U2 and the relative velocity VR2 like this. And then we could assume that the blade angle at inlet is beta 1 like this in this location, and at the outlet here we have beta 2 at this location. If you see the V1 here, the absolute velocity here is the resultant velocity. It is an actual velocity. So we must make sure that all the velocity vectors here need to close loop the resultant velocity. So if you could see here, U1 is from here to here, and then it continues with the VR1. And VWorld1 here until here, and then it is continued with flow velocity 1. At outlet here, we have absolute velocity V2 here as the actual velocity, and then VR2 will start from here to here and then continue with U2 from here to here. For this velocity triangle, we could say that V2 is equal to VF2 because V world at outlet is equal to zero. So this is the velocity triangle at inlet. We also name inlet here as point 1. So this is the velocity triangle at outlet or velocity triangle at point 2. And this is two basic equations that we could calculate by using equation in Francis turbine. It is same with the equation that we use in centrifugal pump. Number one is tangential velocity u. It is equal to pi dn over 60. So when you want to calculate the u1, you need to use diameter at 1 to fulfill this equation. And equation number 2 is flow velocity. We have Vf equal flow rate over the area. If you want to calculate Vf1, you need to use diameter for point number 1 and blade width at point number 1. And then please remember that in Francis turbine, inlet diameter is larger compared to the outlet diameter. Now, I would like to introduce you the Euler head for Francis turbine. Euler head, written as HE for Francis turbine, can be written as HE equal 1 over G, U1 VL1 minus U2 VL2. And normally, VL at point number 2 here will equal to 0. So, we could reduce the Euler head for Francis turbine is equal to U1 VL1 over gravity. The derivation of Euler head for turbine is similar with derivation for pump, except we need to calculate the torque difference between point 1, which is inlet, and point 2, which is outlet. It is because in turbine, the energy is higher at the inlet. At outlet, a part of the fluid's energy has been transferred to the mechanical system. In pump, we calculate the difference between point 2 and point 1. It is because the energy is higher at outlet. To maximize the Euler head, the value of world velocity, VL2, is designed to be 0.